Imagine this. You're walking through a maze and every turn you take is dictated by someone else. You feel lost, confused, and out of control. This is what it feels like to be manipulated. But don't worry, we're here to help you navigate this maze. Today, we're going to explore the 10 most common manipulation techniques and how to spot and avoid them. Lying. Manipulators often lie to create a false reality, hide their true intentions, or avoid accountability. For instance, a salesperson might falsely claim that a product has magical weight loss properties to convince you to buy it. Or a partner might say they were at work all evening when they were actually out with friends. To spot lying, pay attention to the verbal and nonverbal cues of the speaker. To avoid falling for lies, be assertive and honest with yourself and others. Set boundaries and expectations for communication and trust. 2. Gaslighting. This involves making someone doubt their own reality and sanity. A boss might repeatedly deny promising you a raise, making you doubt your memory. Or a friend might insist you never invited them to your party, even though you have evidence of the invitation. To spot gaslighting, trust your own intuition and judgment. To avoid gaslighting, be confident and assertive in your identity and beliefs. Seek support and validation from people who respect and care for you. 3. Guilt tripping. Manipulators use this technique to make you feel guilty or ashamed for something you did or didn't do. A parent might tell their child, "After all I've sacrificed for you, you can't even do this small favor for me." Or a partner might say, "If you really loved me, you'd do what I ask." To spot guilt tripping, recognize and acknowledge your own feelings and needs, and be assertive and confident in your choices and actions. Set boundaries and limits for what you are willing and able to do. 4. Flattery. Manipulators use excessive or insincere praise to charm or seduce their targets. A coworker might constantly praise your work, hoping you'll overlook their mistakes. Or a stranger might compliment your appearance excessively to gain your trust. To spot flattery, be aware of the context and frequency of the compliments. To avoid flattery, be humble and realistic about your own strengths and weaknesses. Be cautious and selective about who you trust and associate with. 5. Fear-mongering. This involves spreading or exaggerating fear to influence your beliefs or actions. A politician might exaggerate the dangers of immigration to manipulate public opinion. Or a marketer might use fear tactics to sell home security systems, emphasizing break-ins and burglaries. To spot fear-mongering, be critical and rational about the information and sources you receive. To avoid fear-mongering, be calm and confident in your own judgment and decision-making. Seek alternative or diverse perspectives and opinions to broaden your understanding and awareness. 6. Love bombing. This involves showering someone with excessive or obsessive love or attention. A new romantic partner might bombard you with affection, gifts, and attention to create dependency. Or a cult leader might shower followers with love and acceptance to keep them loyal. To spot love bombing, be aware of the pace and intensity of the relationship. To avoid love bombing, be cautious and realistic about your own feelings and expectations. Maintain your own identity and independence. 7. Shaming. This involves making someone feel inferior or unworthy. A friend might mock your fashion choices, making you feel embarrassed and inadequate. Or a teacher might publicly criticize a student's incorrect answer, damaging their self-esteem. To spot shaming, recognize and accept your own value and worth. To avoid shaming, be confident and proud of your own identity and uniqueness. Seek support and acceptance from people who respect and care for you. 8. Baiting. This involves luring someone into a trap or conflict. An online troll might deliberately provoke you with offensive comments to elicit an emotional response. Or a coworker might intentionally leave sensitive information on their desk, hoping you'll snoop and get caught. To spot baiting, be aware of the intention and outcome of the interaction. To avoid baiting, be calm and rational in your own response and behavior. Be clear and consistent in your own expectations and boundaries. 9. Triangulation. This involves using a third party to influence or control someone. A manipulative partner might talk to their ex about relationship problems, creating tension and jealousy. Or a supervisor might play two team members against each other to maintain control. To spot triangulation, be aware of the dynamics and relationships between the people or groups involved. To avoid triangulation, be assertive and independent in your own opinions and actions. Maintain or establish direct and honest contact with the people or groups you interact with. 10. Projection. This involves attributing one's own feelings, thoughts, or traits to someone else. A dishonest person might accuse others of lying, or someone with anger issues might claim everyone else is aggressive. To spot projection, be aware of the inconsistency and hypocrisy of the projector. To avoid projection, be assertive and confident in your own identity and reality. Be empathetic and compassionate towards the projector. Manipulation is a common and harmful phenomenon that can affect anyone in any situation. It's important to be aware of the signs of manipulation and how to protect yourself from it. By learning and applying these tips and strategies, you can spot and avoid these common manipulation techniques. Remember, your mind is your own. Let's keep it that way.